Welcome back. I'm joined here with Captain Josh Kiley from, my goodness, words are hard for me this morning. Josh Kyle. My gosh, I apologize.
No worries. Two first names.
It's tough. You're like David George. You got the man with two names here.
There you go.
But I wanted you to expand a little bit here on the police training officer program that you guys have at the Riley County Police Department. Give me some details and why does it stand out from other training programs?
The police training officer program was created in the 90s. It was designed from the very beginning to get officers to not only problem solve, but to be critical thinkers and to work with the community to solve community problems. Historically, officers ride with officers, other experienced officers, after they get out of the academy. And what this program does is you do continue to ride with officers, but you're also handed problem assignments that you're expected to get through. And they typically culminate in a presentation from the recruit. We just had a series of them this last week. And they're actually really amazing to watch the newest members of your agency stand in front of everybody from senior police officers to command staff and present what they've learned because of their problem assignment. The latest one I saw was involving a traffic stop where the people at the traffic stop are not necessarily cooperative. And the question for the recruit is, how do you handle these kinds of situations without it escalating into uses of force or some other kind of unfortunate incident?
And so you've seen really good results from these programs, obviously.
Absolutely. It's a cultural shift that's occurred in the agency over the last about 20 years. We've been doing the police training officer program for about 15 or so years, and we're just now seeing this change in mentality of people in our organization really viewing situations that come across as a problem that requires solving, and where are the resources to solve that problem. It's a shift in mentality.
Sounds like a very good shift, too.
I think so. Yeah.
And shifting now to school safety, schools just started back up. What kind of tips do you have for parents to keep their kiddos safe when they're, you know, getting on and off the school bus or just things around school?
I would say the biggest thing as a parent of teens right now is have a talk with your kids. Make certain that they understand that if they're handed something at school, it's not something that they want to ingest. Unfortunately, there's kids out there with a lot of different items, everything from things that look like pills that actually contain fentanyl. It's very dangerous. But it can look like candy, too. There's a number of products out there that look like they're candy, but they're really not. So have the talk with especially your teens and let them know that if just because somebody offers them something at school and they don't know this person very well or they have any doubts at all, it's best not to ingest it.
All right. Well, thank you so much for speaking with us today. I think that's all that we have for you. And happy Tuesday. Hopefully words will be better for me today.
All right. Have a good one.
All right. You too.